In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to access single-cell gene expression data on the GTEx portal. We have begun performing single-cell gene expression using snRNA-seq. You can navigate to the single-cell dataset documentation by selecting the single-cell menu and choosing the dataset overview item. As shown on this page, we used 25 archived frozen tissue samples from 16 donors previously collected as part of the GTEx project. We have profiled 8 tissues: breast, esophagus mucosa, esophagus muscularis, heart, lung, skeletal muscle, prostate, and skin. The single-cell gene expression matrices are available for download from the GTEx portal open access data page, and you can navigate to that using the downloads menu and choosing the open access data item. The snRNA-seq data is right here at the top. The protected access data is only available on Anvil, as described on the protected access data page, which you can navigate to selecting downloads, protected access data. We have 2 different visualizations available for the single cell data, depending upon whether you are interested in the expression of a single gene or a list of genes. If you have a single gene of interest, you can search for that gene in the search bar. I will search for the gene P10. Scrolling down on the page, you will find the single-cell gene expression visualization below the visualization for bulk expression. By default, the data is sorted by cell type. I'm going to zoom in a little bit here. But if you click the T button, this will group the violin plots by tissue. The gray dots here show the number of cells that were sequenced for the given cell type in the given tissue. For example, if we mouse over the first gray dot, you will see that our sample size is 2,135 adipocyte cells in breast mammary tissue. The size of the gray dot is proportional to the sample size. The pop-up also shows us that the gene P10 was detected in 1,387 of these 2,135 cells, or 64.96% of the cells. This percentage is displayed in the blue pie chart labeled cell fraction. Looking down at the violin plots, there is one violin plot per tissue cell type. The vertical axis is the log of read counts per 10,000 reads for this gene. Mousing over the violin plots for breast mammary tissue, we can see that P10 is expressed more highly in adipocyte cells than in the other cells. By default, the visualization displays data from all cells, but by selecting the non-zero button, this changes the display to only displaying data from cells where we detected the gene of interest. You can see how for cell types where P10 was only detected in a small fraction of cells, selecting this option significantly changes median and allows us to see more detail in the violin plots. We can also download this visualization in SVG format using the download button. If you have multiple genes of interest, you can go to the single cell menu item and select the multi-gene single cell query page. When this page loads, it's populated with an example set of genes, but you can search for your genes of interest. I will enter P10, EGFR, APC, and EPCAM, and then press the search button. By default, the visualization is grouped by tissue, but I will group by cell type by pressing the cell type button. And we're going to zoom in a little bit. If we mouse over one of the data points, we see additional detail about that data point. The default mode for this visualization is an aster plot, where the size and color are proportional to the expression, so darker, larger circles are more highly expressed. The colored arc in the circle shows the percentage of cells in which the gene was detected. If we look at the adipocyte cells in the EGFR row for breast mammary tissue, we can see this arc covers about 1/3 of the circle. And looking at the pop-up, we can see that EGFR was detected in about 34% of those cells. We can download this plot in SVG format by selecting the download button.